In this video demonstration, we'll be looking at installing and configuring the Distributed File System role service. We'll begin by installing DFS, we'll then look at creating a namespace, configuring folder targets, and finish the demonstration with folder replication. Okay, so let's begin by installing and configuring the Distributed File System role service. So on CServer 1, let's go into roles. We'll click on File Services. And we can see that DFS is currently not installed, so we're going to add Role Services. We'll select DFS. Select Next on the wizard. Choose to create a namespace later, so next, and just go ahead and install. With that done, we're going to switch to NYC DC1 and perform the same task. So again, into File Services, we're going to scroll down, add Role Services, select DFS, next, choose to create a namespace later, next, and install. And that's now done. Okay, now what we want to do on NYC Server 1, we're going to go ahead and create the DFS namespace. So, under Administrative Tools, let's go into DFS Management. And under DFS Management, we're going to click on Namespaces. And we're going to right click and select a new namespace. Under the server name, we'll type in NYC-SVR1. And for the name, we'll type in Corp Docs. We're going to choose a domain based namespace. And enable Server 2008 mode. From there we'll hit Create. Okay, we can see that's now done, so we're just going to press on Close. And from there we'll click on contoso.com corp docs under namespaces. From there we'll click on Namespace Servers. We'll right click and go into Properties, and under Advanced we're going to enable Access Base Enumeration for this namespace. What that does is it hides folders in the namespace that users do not have permissions to use. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to add the Marketing Templates folder to the Corp Docs namespace. So we're going to add a new folder. In the name, we're going to type in Marketing Templates. And under the folder targets, we'll click Add. And we'll point to /NYC-DC1/Marketing Templates. And click OK. We'll then add a new folder. And in there, we're going to type in policy files. In the add folder target, we'll point to /NYC-server1/policy files. and hit OK. Now what we now want to do is verify the CorpDocs namespace. So we'll click on start and we'll just type in the URL contoso.com/CorpDocs. And what we want to see is we want to see marketing templates and policy files visible in the window that opens. And we can see that that's the case. In our last exercise, we're going to look at configuring DFS folder replication. So under policy files, we're going to add a new folder target. We're going to point the new target to nycdc1/policy files. Now we should see a warning asking us, do we want to create a shared folder? As we can see, we do, and we'll just say yes. We'll type the path to the shared folder to be in c:\policy files. And under the shared folder permissions, we're going to select administrators have full access, other users have read and write. From there, the replication group dialog box appears and we'll click yes. Now this will launch a new wizard. From there we click next. Under eligibility, we'll click next. The primary member, we're going to make NYC Server 1. And we want a full mesh topology. We're going to replicate continuously using full bandwidth and hit create. Okay, we're done, we hit close and look at the replication delay message. Now from here, under replication, under our members, under NYC DC1, we're going to choose to make read only. Now under replication, we're going to choose to create a diagnostic report and it's going to be a general health report. We'll select our members, we'll select our reference member and hit create. And we'll wait for this to compile on the machine and then we'll view the report. And we can see we've got no errors, but we've got one warning. We look at the warning, the DFS replication service is restarting frequently. And to be honest, the reason we've got that is because it's only just started up on our virtual environment.